In the last video, we have learned how to pass data to the child component using props. We can also pass HTML markup to the component using view slots. Let's see how it works. To show you an example of view slot, I have included here Bootstrap CSS, jQuery, and Bootstrap JS. So here I will create a Bootstrap card component. In Bootstrap, card markup is something like this. It's a div, class is card, next div, card body, and let's add some dummy content. And in the browser, refresh, it looks like this. Now here what I'll do, I'll create a card component in Vue.js so that we can do something like this. Here we'll add a card tag, and inside this card tag we can print some text and it will render this markup. So let's create this. Here I'll create Vue.component. Component name is card. Next, here we'll pass template. Now here we'll add a card markup and let's remove this. Now our card component is created. So here we can add card, and inside this we can add some markup like paragraph tag. Refresh. Here the card is created, but we cannot see the text. So to print this text inside the component, we use a slot. So here we'll add slot tag. Now you go to browser, refresh again, and you can see the text is printed here. Let's print something else. Refresh, and it's working. Now you can see we can print any markup inside this card tag here using this slot. We can also provide default content here, like default text. Now if we remove this, refresh, and you will see default text. We add the text here again. Refresh, the default text is replaced with the lorem text. Now what about if we have multiple places where we want to add dynamic content? For example, here we have h5 class card title and here title. In the browser it looks like this. Now how we can render title here from this tag? For that we use named slot. So here we'll say slot name is equal to title. So now here we'll add div slot is title, and let's add random text. Now let's see this browser, refresh, and it's working. But if we see this in inspect tool, you will see in the h5 tag this div is rendered. Here you might not want to print this div tag inside this tag. In that case, here we use template. Now if we go to browser, refresh. Now title is printed inside the h5 tag. Here you can see if we do not provide any slot name, it will be considered this default slot. Now here you must remember that this slot attribute is deprecated in the Vue version 2.6 and it will be officially removed in the version 3. So instead of this, you should use v-slot colon and the slot name. Refresh, and it is working. Or you can use shorthand hash title, the slot name, and refresh, and it is working. Let's see one more example of slot, and this time I will create Bootstrap model component. Bootstrap model markup is this one. Let's copy this, and here I'll say view component. Component name is model, and here we'll pass template. Let's paste markup here. Model components is created. Now we can print model tag here. In the browser, by default, it is hidden. So to trigger the model, you will say button btn btn primary data toggle equal to model and data target is equal to this my model. Let's see this. It's not working. Okay, here is the hash. Yes, this is working. Now here I'll pass this ID dynamically, so we can add as many model we want. So here I'll say ID is equal to my model, and here we'll accept that props ID. Now here we'll say bind ID. Refresh, it's working. And now in this model I want to render dynamic content, and it will be print right here. So here I'll add slot tag, and let's pass a lorem text. In the browser, refresh model, and it's working. Similarly, if we want to add title here, so I'll say slot name is equal to title, and here we'll pass title template as title random title, and it is working. Now this model is reusable component, and we can add as many models we want. Let's see an example. So here, let's copy this and paste it right here. Let's say here model 2, and its title is model 2 title. And remove this lorem text, and text is some content. In the browser, refresh. Oops, it need not worked. Actually, we forgot to change this data target. So here we'll say model 2, and this model ID is model 2. Now let's see this in browser, refresh, and here it is model 2, and this one is the first model. This is all in this video. If you like the video, hit the like button, share this video, and don't forget to subscribe us. See you in the next video.